During these COVID times, we have not only reacted to the needs of our community, we have truly increased our services, our collaborative efforts with other organizations, and our overall reach to South Asians in Minnesota. We have done this by undergoing major escalation of our meals program, distributing information on COVID with state and county government, assigning a victim response team, and holding weekly and monthly meetings and services for specific communities such as women, victims, seniors, youth, and LGBTQ+. For our seniors especially, and our victims, we have also dedicated significant time for telephone assurance and limited in-person visits. Tears were falling down her cheek as we made an in-person visit to one senior. She had fallen the night before, trying to turn on the light and lost her balance. She told me, "You're not even family, but you take care of me, calling me every week, delivering meals and groceries, and having the Friday social. God bless you." These wellness calls and checks are done up to 3 times weekly to assess any immediate needs. This also is a significant way we keep our community engaged and contribute positively to their mental health.
There's a high neglect in the community on the seniors that have fallen down the cracks, and we are here for them, meeting their basic needs. There are food shelves, but people have to go to them. Disabled people have no way of getting to the food shelf to pick up and bring those food with them.
About 100 meals per day we are sending out right now.
Mahatma Gandhi said, "Manava sevi madava sevak." Human service is divine service. We are doing that kind of work. We are making difference in the community.
This is the right time for people to step up and take care of everybody around us. I feel more than ever what SEWA is doing is very, very crucial right now. This is a message going out to everybody who's out there that they are not alone.
Groceries are being sponsored, food is being delivered. Many families who would have gone to bed hungry are not.
Many seniors live by themselves and they are alone. I think this time, more than any time before, people need help.
SEWA is all about compassion. They are dealing with the issues which are largely ignored by our South Asian community. For me, it's giving back to the community and working with some great people at SEWA.
When I drop food to the seniors who are isolated, I can feel the reaction from them. When you are in a tough situation, whatever comes to you, you will never forget.
As part of an effort with the Minnesota Department of Health and Hennepin County, we have been distributing masks and PPE and providing information to our community, both in English and in Hindi, about safe practices, testing procedures, and testing locations.
As part of our response to stress and anxiety during COVID-19, we started providing free and confidential mental health consultations by culturally specific therapists. Though the South Asian community is extremely reluctant to discuss mental health, the demand for these services has only grown, and we can see progress in breaking down the stigma surrounding depression and other mental health concerns. We also have many ongoing meetups, such as our Chai and Chat Women's Group, South Asian Queer League meetups to support the South Asian LGBTQ+ community in the Midwest, a women's reading group, DOOR, Desi Online Reading, and Brown Breakfast Club for the Youth. We are really encouraged to see new faces join in for the monthly Zoom discussions in our women's forum Chai and Chat, where we discuss various issues related to immigrant women's life, coping mechanisms, and self-care. The discussions in these meetups are playing a crucial role in building community and spreading awareness about the importance of mental health.
South Asian Queer League, SAQL, in Urdu Hindi means face and identity. SEWA-AIFW supports all our queer, trans, non-binary, LGBTQ plus individuals and their struggles. SEWA-AIFW also trains South Asians to become better allies to fight against homo and transphobia among South Asian communities in diaspora. We inaugurated our programming for South Asian LGBTQ plus individuals in Minnesota in February 2020. Soon after that, in March, the lockdown was announced because of COVID-19. We continued serving our proud members and offered mental health support via Zoom online. Shakil offers once a month mental health peer support group Satrangi Meetup with a culturally specific psychotherapist. We realized that the pandemic has been adversely affecting the mental health of LGBTQ plus individuals who are stuck inside homes with their unsupportive parents and siblings. While coming out is not an option for all, the pandemic has been more harmful and suffocating for many. We remind them all time and again that SEWA is with you, even virtually now. One of the focus areas SEWA-AIFW has is bringing systemic changes to socioeconomic disparities that exist in our cultural communities. One such program is DAVAIDAVAI, Domestic Abuse and Violence Awareness Initiative.
As youth and young adults spend more time at home amidst the pandemic, it's important that they still feel connected with their peers. Brown Breakfast Club is one group in which we talk about ways to support yourself and your friends through times like these. This group is limited to ages 16 through 24 in order to provide a safe and comfortable space to have open discussion. Our main focus is on mental health and violence prevention, which is currently being accomplished through virtual meetings.
Sadly, as a result of the pandemic, our needs for culturally specific victim services has increased dramatically. Many victims are stuck at home with their abusers, especially if one or both of them are also dealing with a job loss or a shift to working from home. Every day we are getting 10 to 15 calls, and our advocate team is addressing the needs of those individuals. Today, we have reached more than 5,000 survivors. Our Chai and Chat program, as well as weekly calls and telephone assurance, help these victims stay connected and feel supported.